there are no political parties in the United States. You don't participate in a political party. You can push a button, but that's very different than participating in forming programs. In fact, the United States is basically a one-party state. It has the business party, the Tories, with two factions, supported by different segments of the business community, shifting segments of the business community. Let's go back to the 1984 elections and notice what the population was asked to vote on. The Republicans were the party of Keynesian growth. They were the party of deficit financing, huge state subsidy to industry, huge debts, in the hope that somehow things would be taken care of. So the Republicans were saying, you know, follow us, we'll have growth at the cost of huge debt, later generations will worry about it. The Democrats were the party of fiscal conservatism. They were saying, look, you got to worry about the consequences, you can't just, you know, make checks and have a powerful state that's interfering in the economy and so on and so forth. Now, the population was given a choice between damn the consequences, a jingoist Keynesian growth, and we believe, you know, we accept, we really agree with you, but we're afraid of the consequences, fiscal conservatism. So they voted for the thing that made them feel more upbeat. Notice, incidentally, that the two parties shifted their traditional positions. Well, that was easy because the parties don't stand for anything anyway. They just reflect different sectors of the business community. The Democrats reflected interests of investment bankers and people who cared about money and so on. And, you know, the population ended up voting for the people who made them feel better.
And people but like it.
No, they don't like it. They generally, in fact, that's where you're wrong. I don't think people like being outside the system. That 50% of the population that says the system's run by a few big interests looking out for themselves is not happy about it. They just don't see any alternative. They've been atomized. Their organizations have been broken up. A working class culture has been dissolved. It used to exist. You have to go back to the 1930s. At that time, there was a live working class culture with its own organizations, institutions, everything from the newspapers to picnics. It took a long time to break that down. In other countries, which are not as advanced as the United States, it was broken down later. Let's say take England. Very interesting case. England is a generation or two behind the United States in this process. In England, they still have a Labour Party, though they won't for long. In England, up until the 1960s, they had a very lively Labour-based press, which created a, which was very large. The Daily Herald had much more readership than the famous newspapers, the Times, the Guardian, and so on. And it had extensive participation on the part of the readers. It couldn't survive conditions of the market. I mean, the market is designed so that dissidents are excluded, naturally. It couldn't get advertising and so on and so forth. So it disappeared by the 60s, and so did the rest of the social democratic press. And with it went the cultural basis for an alternative vision of the way society ought to be organized. And gradually, participation in that dissident culture also dissolved. The Labour Party will go the same way, and other industrial democracies, capitalist democracies, will also go the same way.